Guys, what's going on?
Nick.
Been a while since I've done one. Hey, at least I've done one more recent than Heffy. That bastard said he had one in the pipe ready to upload and he hasn't done it yet. That was before he went to Jamaica. Fucking bastard. Anyways, using my phone again. Hopefully it's gonna work this time. Maybe give me a little better quality. I'll look at one here today. It's had it for a little while. Hopefully it's still good. This one is from a brewery in Ontario, Nickelbrook Brewing Company, Continental Drift, Belgian Style, Pale Ale. What can we tell you about Nickelbrook? Well, I've seen guys like Chad from the Albino Rhino. He's done some for Nickelbrook, and I think some of the other yahoos that I follow have done them. Anyways, Nickelbrook. Burlington, Ontario. ABV 5.6%, 40 IBUs. So, this one, I don't know anything about it. Matter of fact, I got this experimental pack that they had, that Nickelbrook put out when I was last in Ontario back in the summertime. Yeah, I've had this for a while. Not much I can tell you because I don't know what the other ones were like. Yeah, I think I was that drunk. Well, I'm going to use my delirium glass because, well, it's Belgian. This is a Belgian style beer. I'll use a Belgian glass. Oh, definitely a nice golden color. Look at that. I've never heard anything bad about this brewery. Mostly because I don't remember what the beers were like when I had them. But, yeah, by the way, it says unfiltered. Yeah, somewhat opaque.
Hello?
Yeah, the leaf on the phone's going through, definitely giving that a nice golden sheen inside. Not as unfiltered as I was expecting, but still looks damn good. What do we got here? Continental drift is the movement of the world's continents relative to each other. In honor of this phenomenon, we bring together Europe and North America with our Continental Drift Belgian Pale Ale. We utilize the spicy fruitiness of Belgian yeast and enhance this with the tropical dank resins of American Amarillo and Columbus hops. The result is a remarkably refreshing and flavorful combining of forces that will move your world. Tectonically awesome. Well, that remains to be seen. Yeah, this is from the A Miracle of Science series, I believe. Couldn't be all that bad, because I probably would have remembered, so. Yeah, looks good. Yeah, definitely has the fruitiness of the Belgian, that you normally expect from Belgian. Somewhat banana-y. Apricot, pear. Definitely smells nice and sweet. The IBUs on the high side, I'm not gonna expect it to be really bitter. But I don't expect it to be sweet either. Definitely not gonna be as sweet as it smells. Is definitely getting the, like I said, banana, apricot, pear, candy sugar. Is that what I'm getting? I don't know. Anybody else who's had this, they will know better than me. Because I'm just an average Joe who likes to drink beer in his basement. Well, the other guys might call me an asshole that drinks beer in his basement, but whatever. Anyways, guys. How's your week going so far? This is my weekend. It's Tuesday, March 21st at present, for another hour. Yes, it's 11 o'clock p.m. here in New Brunswick. Anyways, enough yammering. I know you didn't come here to hear me talk, so let's drink. Definitely not as sweet as it smells. Definitely getting piney resin or evergreen resin, like on that spectrum. Definitely more resin, like the pine, but definitely get some, like the rind of a grapefruit in there. What else am I getting? Maybe a little bit of passion fruit? Maybe. It's really faint. But like the, you can definitely get it on the, at the back of the throat. Yeah, back of the throat. I opened up a target there. Go ahead, Ed, Effie, Eric, if you decide to take the time to watch this on your busy schedule, go ahead. Lay it on in there. You know you want to. Yeah, no, that's actually pretty decent. Yeah, that's about what I'm getting. Enough complexity in there that to make it interesting. It's not my preferred, but I'll definitely enjoy it. Do I get it again? Probably not. Not to mention, can't really get this around here anyways. New Brunswick doesn't get Nickelbrook. Just like they don't get a lot of stuff from that Ontario yet, but hey, we're not important. Yeah, I'm quite enjoy this. But I would not get it again. Why? Because there's so many other beers out there to try. So, I am going to give that one 7. Still really good. But I wish I had more stuff in Nickelbrook to try. But that's not the case, so I'll stop there on that. And we'll just go on with our days. Excuse me. Cheers, guys. Have yourself a good one.